Believe it or not, April is already here. And while we may not have had as many jokes thrown at us this year because of, well, we still have a bunch of new games coming our way.
Hey, you! Yeah, you! Are you seriously playing Animal Crossing right now? Shouldn't you be sick and tired of farming eggs already?
I'm Zian from Nintendo Life, and today we're going to be taking a look at 11 new exciting games releasing on the Nintendo Switch in the month of April. We'll be listing these games off in the order that they release. So without further ado, let's take a look at the list. If you're old enough to remember the Nokia brick, you're likely to remember the game Snake. It's a classic game in which you maneuver a little snake that, as it eats food, it gets bigger, and you basically have to try to make it not run into itself. Well, on April 2nd, which has already probably happened by now, the Nintendo Switch is being treated to a sort of spiritual successor to Snake, I guess, called Snakey Bus. God, just saying that's ridiculous. Instead, as you could probably guess by now, you play as a bus that drives around a city at lightning speeds, picking up civilians, and the more you pick up, the longer your bus becomes. While the overall goal seems to be fairly simple, it still looks like a ton of over-the-top fun and gives me some serious Crazy Taxi vibes. There seems to be a good variety in levels, as some will let you drive around cities and others just let you drive around office buildings with Hot Wheel-esque tracks everywhere. The price point may be a bit high at 12 bucks, but depending on your style, it could be a game that you pull a lot of time out of. Launching on April 7th is the latest entry in the survival action series, Disaster Report 4 Summer Memories. The world has been hit by a massive earthquake, leaving Japan in total ruin, and you happen to be right in the thick of it. Throughout your journey to safety, you'll meet a slew of fellow survivors who can either help or hinder your progress, but the choice to help them is yours. The game looks like it can be a bit cheesy at times, but the absolute terror of aftershocks and collapsing buildings sure seem like they'll make up for it. Also dropping on Nintendo Switch that same day is a hack and slash platformer called Grim Valor. Now right off the bat, you can tell this game has a pretty interesting combat system a la Dark Souls dodging that allows you to pull off a ton of slick combos. Throughout the game, you'll face an onslaught of gigantic bosses that'll give you new weapons and equipment to prepare for your next encounter. When this game originally launched on iOS a few years back, it received pretty rave reviews from critics, so we have pretty high hopes for this one's life on Switch. Kicking off their closed beta on the 9th is a new free-to-play looter shooter on Switch called Vigor. Taking place in a post-war version of Norway, you play as another just trying to survive in this world of chaos. From what I've read, it seems like the main goal of the game is to loot as much as you can during the 8 to 12 player firefights, and bring whatever you've nabbed back to your shelter to upgrade your loadouts. So if you prefer to just stealth your way through maps, gather supplies, and get out, you can absolutely do that. It seems like an interesting mechanic, but I've never heard of anything else out there like it. So if you're into these type of games and your backlog isn't looking too terrible, then why not give it a shot? What do you have to lose? It's free. And following that up on the 14th is a game that sort of caught me off guard. Whenever I create these lists, I try to make sure I look at every game that's coming out for the month on Switch. And let me tell you, when I looked at this game Boot Hill Bounties, I never expected it to be a turn-based RPG in the style of Earthbound. Now, Boot Hill Bounties is a Wild West adventure that plays very similar to the classic RPGs found on the Super Nintendo, but with a ton of modern conveniences. Random battles are thrown completely to the wayside, allowing you to fight whenever you want. But you can also bring a few friends with you to join in on the fights as well, as the game supports four-player co-op, which is sort of unique for a turn-based RPG. And of course, another major highlight of this spaghetti western is definitely its humor. Fights can break out against anyone, from a few cowboys in a saloon to a bison and its squirrel companions. This game looks absolutely strange, but in the best way, and it should definitely be on your radar if you're into RPGs, even if you aren't the type for westerns. Then if we jump ahead to the 16th, we're being treated to Billion Road, which sort of looks like a mashup between Monopoly, Dokapon Kingdom, and Fortune Street, if I had to guess. Up to four players essentially traverse this board game city, investing in as many establishments as possible to become the richest person in town while also keeping the city safe from monsters. As you roll dice and make your way down the board, you'll encounter monsters that will either curse you or give you additional abilities to help you make more money. The game also offers plenty of different game modes for shorter and longer play sessions too. So if you're stuck at home like the majority of us are, and you need something new to play with the family, this could be a worthy contender for your next game night. And then, launching on the 22nd is probably my most anticipated game for the month. This is a game called Ida. The trailer starts out showing the protagonist waking up to find her family absolutely slaughtered. But thankfully, the spirit of her cat is here to help guide her through this unknown world she's trapped in. Now, I initially thought this was going to be some sort of kind of mysterious adventure puzzler, until out of nowhere, the main character just pulls out a gun and starts blasting enemies. She even gets a cloud-like Buster Sword at one point. Like, what's going on? I never expected this to be a bullet hell boss rush shooter. The art style, the cutscenes, the audio, every single part of this game checks a certain box for me, and it reminds me a lot of games like Jodun and Titan Souls, and it looks like this game is going to put up quite the challenge, but I don't want to know more. I'm already sold. Just let me play the game! And then, launching on the 24th, is Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Storm 4 Road to Boruto. This latest entry in the Naruto fighting game series marks the conclusion of the Shippuden story, and picks right back up with the son of Naruto, Boruto. It includes a new 3v3 fighting mode, and features over 120 different playable characters. And unlike most fighting games, it also features a full adventure mode that allows you to freely roam around and interact with characters outside of battle. It seems like the world gets a new Naruto game more often than we get a new Dragon Ball game these days, but these Naruto games are always a treat to look at. They're super flashy and fun to play, and honestly, you can't beat that. Also launching on the 24th of April is a game many of us have been eagerly awaiting. We're talking about Trials of Mana, a full-on remake of the classic Super Famicom title Seiken Densetsu 3. This classic RPG is being entirely reborn for a new era, taking on a new third-person camera, featuring a lovable cast of fully voiced characters, and a brand new epilogue chapter. Now, the original version of this game was originally released for the first time in the West last year with the Collection of Mana package, but if you're curious to get a taste of what this new version of Trials of Mana has to offer, there's a demo available on the eShop that you can give a shot right now. And then launching on the 28th is a brand new game from the makers of Death Squared, called Moving Out. In this job simulation game, up to four players must attempt to move boxes, furniture, and just about anything you can think of out of houses, planes, and moving vehicles, much in the style of Overcooked. It'll either be frantic fun or chaos, if you can't get your friends to cooperate accordingly. And just like a few other titles on this list, Moving Out also has a demo available on the eShop right now that you can try before you fully commit to the game. And finally, capping off our list on April 30th is the adventure platformer Level Head. And this isn't just your ordinary platformer either, as it's built entirely around its massive level designer. You can fully design your own levels from the ground up and share them online for anyone to play, much like Super Mario Maker. The game does also feature its own full campaign as well if you'd prefer to stay offline and just play the game. It's also been in early access on PC for a while now and has gained quite the following. So if you're looking for a new platformer to keep you busy, this game shouldn't ever have a shortage of levels to play. And there you have it, a handful of games releasing on the Nintendo Switch in the month of April. It is pretty interesting to not see a single Nintendo IP on the list this month, but there are some pretty strong third-party titles like Trials of Mana that should be serving the Switch pretty well. Feel free to let us know in the comments down below which of these games you're most excited to get your hands on, and let us know of anything that you think should have made it onto our list. And as always, if you enjoyed this video and you want to see more content like this, then why don't you craft that subscribe button into a piece of egg furniture, and ring that notification bell to be notified whenever we release new videos. Thank you all so much for watching. I'm Zian from Nintendo Life. Please continue to stay safe out there, and we will see you next time.